multiplication in this area. It's crowded. Sitting down at lunch, but there's actually a medical emergency on the train.
Yeah.
And we stopped at a place called Cantwell. So we'll just see what happens. Yeah, there was a medical emergency. Unfortunately. Looks like the family that's here. Looking to transport her somewhere else. I guess it's a good sign she walked in the ambulance. Yeah. sick. Let's see, she's walked into the ambulance, so it's a good sign. Name of the town, but it's about 100 miles or about hours north of Anchorage.
Oh yeah.
And they launch, everybody gets together and launch all these old cars off this 300-foot cliff. And you know, they got trophy made out of car parts, and everybody down below. It's like a big redneck party down there.
Sounds like food. I'll have to check it out.
Yeah, it and they got a bunch of food vendors show up. I mean, it's a big thing, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, it's pretty neat. 4th of July, it's a big to-do thing, because, you know, they don't do fireworks up there on 4th of July.
Yeah, that's only one town where you can do it.
That's saved for New Year's Eve. It's when they light off fireworks.
Yeah.
So, so they do other things like that up here. I'm going to be there on 4th of July. I've convinced my son to take me up there.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah, no worries. No.
only got a couple people that have had me. Oh, here comes some more. We'll see how we do. Like they said on the intercom, a 20-ish minute break. So they had to transfer some personnel over from the northbound train. Which would be a pretty interesting job.
Is it in view yet?
Not yet. Okay.
What is coming up ahead here?
Hurricane Gulch.
Oh.
They said you can fit the Statue of Liberty down inside of it.
Really?
It's deep.
Yeah, it's deep.
That's it deep. Is deep.
Dummies of statues of all these animals that you saw.
but you save on the way.
Yep.
In a moment, everybody, it's Hurricane Gulch. You might be wondering why it's called Hurricane. This is due to the fact that it has hurricane-like winds ranging up to 90 miles per hour. Don't worry, folks, though, we are going to be slowing the train down to around 10 miles per hour as we cross it. This bridge was actually built starting on either side and built inward through an aerial system.
Here to go camping, fishing, hiking, rafting for all sorts of reasons.
getting out here because there is no road access for the next few miles until we get to Talkeetna. Anyways, the only way they're getting out here is by using that flag. Now, if you ever find yourself in Talkeetna and you've got a few hours to spare, I highly suggest hopping on the hurricane train, ride it up to Hurricane Gulch, and you'll meet a lot of very interesting characters on that train, from all the adventurers to all the locals that have camels out here. It's a pretty fun train, and it's a pretty neat experience if you're ever in Talkeetna.
No, I didn't want any. Thank you. We're going to be coming into Anchorage pretty soon. Right now we're at Jay Bear. We're kind of rolling through the middle of the military base there. That's pretty neat. So I got off the train here in Anchorage. Now I'm heading over to Jay Bear, where I get to stay on the military base. My second favorite thing on this trip.